Hi everyone, thank you for joining. A couple of days ago, I posted a picture of hummus I made at home, and I got a lot of questions on the recipe and how the presentation was done. So I thought I'll go live and show you actually how it's done. This recipe is tried and tested in my kitchen several times, and I've had a couple of alterations done each time actually, based on how I wanted the taste, if I wanted a little nutty flavor, if I wanted a little sourness through the lemon. But try this recipe out once it's done, and trust me, you will really like it. If you had attended my episode on essential ingredients in the kitchen, you must have noticed chickpeas was very much there. And I find hummus on the list of essential edibles in the kitchen. In the fridge, you need to have hummus. Please learn this recipe. It's excellent. It has a lot of nutritional benefits. It's good for kids, it's good for adults, it's a great party entertainer snack, and it has lots of nutritional benefits. If I have my nutritional friends here, Avanti, Mrudul, either of you here, I'm sure you can vouch for this, that chickpea is absolutely healthy, and the recipe and hummus is going to be an excellent addition to your kitchen. So let's go ahead. I'm going to go through the entire recipe with you in a fast forward way. I'm not going to be showing you the pressure cooker, how it's the whistles and everything, because I already have a lot which is cooked. And let's go into my kitchen and let's begin. So right till the presentation, I am absolutely going to be teaching you. So let's begin here. I'm switching the camera off to the other side, which is just give me a minute. There it is. Let's start. Chickpeas. Okay, chickpeas, chana, chole, garbanzo beans, you can call them whatever names. These are the ones in a raw state. To make hummus, you have to soak them. I prefer soaking them minimum 8 hours or overnight. This is what happens when you soak them. Now, if you notice, the weight of this is 1 cup of raw chickpeas after soaking overnight, gives you this amount, this volume. Okay, so you might feel that when I'm soaking, 1 cup may not be enough for a party, may not be enough for a family of guests coming over, a few friends coming over, but please note, it doubles in volume. So 1 cup of raw chickpeas became 2 cups of soaked chickpeas. Okay, so this is overnight. And now these need to be cooked. When I cook them, they maintain the same 2 cup volume. They do not get less, nor do they increase in volume. So I hope you understood. 1 cup of raw gives you 2 cup of soaked chickpeas, which gives you 2 cups of cooked chickpeas. Now, when it comes up to cooking these chickpeas, I use a pressure cooker method. Okay, I have my pressure cooker here. I have my plate, I have water. This goes in with a little bit of water. Okay, the water quantity is very minimum. So we are going to be adding a little bit of water to this chickpeas, and I'm going to be pressure cooking this. Just about this much of water, and I'm going to be pressure cooking this. Now, pressure cook is for these cholas, chickpeas, I have done 7 whistles, which is 4 whistles on a full flame and 3 whistles on a low flame. Okay, so just keep in mind, this takes time to cook. It is not a 1 whistle thing. Chickpeas take time. So this is going to be going on the gas. For full flame, 4 whistles, and low flame, 3 whistles. But of course, right now is not the time to do that. So this is what happens. This is what I get. Okay, cooked chickpeas. Now, if you notice, chickpeas do have a sort of a covering. Okay, can you see this? The skin. If you have time, do take it out for a smoother and a creamier hummus. Otherwise, let them be. So I'm just going to take out the ones which I can actually see we are very visible, otherwise it's just going to be going ahead making the hummus. Now another thing, when I pressure cooked, I got this liquid. This liquid is called aquafaba. Okay, I'm not going to go too much into the depth, but just for you to know, aquafaba is basically a direct replacement for egg whites. This can be used in making meringues, it can be used for making marshmallows. So don't throw this water. We can either use it in making hummus a little bit, or if you're going to be using, you're a baker, you need to use this. Aquafaba is what this is called, and this can be used as a good replacement for egg whites. Now moving on, if you want to cook your chickpeas with salt in it, you can do it at the pressure cooker stage. If not, just keep it in mind while making hummus. If you've added salt while cooking, you need to omit salt at the processing stage. If you have totally kept the salt, basically just keep in mind. I don't want double salt going, and the cooking stage as well as the processing is going to definitely get salty. So I hope you understood the chickpea part here, the cooking as well as the skin removal in case if there is any, and the aquafaba which is here present. Moving on, the other ingredients that we have, a very important ingredient, which is tahini paste. This is a roasted, this paste is made out of roasted and ground sesame seeds. Very important, there is no replacement for this. Okay, so for hummus you definitely need this paste. I have a little bit of salt. My garlic proportion basically goes 1 cup of cooked chickpeas for and 1 clove of garlic. I don't want it to be a very garlicky hummus, especially when you're entertaining, you have friends over, you don't want people to have your hummus and, you know, keep having a garlicky breath. So just go easy on the garlic. 1 cup, 1 clove of garlic. So I have 2 cups, so I have 2 cloves of garlic. Lemon juice. Okay, now moving on to the processing. Food processor is what you definitely need. So this is the only equipment you're going to be needing for making hummus. Why a food processor is basically because it churns everything very well. In a blender, what happens is it tends to just keep getting pureed and, you know, pasty kind just at the bottom of the blender. It doesn't give you an overall finish. So let's start with the processing. Now, cooked chickpeas, you can make hummus while the chickpeas are hot. You can make hummus while the chickpeas are cold. What will happen is, you know, you have put the cooker on, the chickpeas are done, and you realize you need to rush out of the house. Don't worry, store the chickpeas in the fridge. You can always come back and make hummus. So I'm making hummus of cold chickpeas. I am taking this visible skin out. Okay. In goes the chickpeas. I'm going to be pureeing this first before I add the rest of the ingredients. Just a little bit. Okay. Now is the time to add my tahini paste. Okay. I'm adding in the tahini paste. The recipe will be put up later. I'm adding in the tahini paste. Now tahini paste has a very, very strong taste. So if you add it in excess, the hummus does get a little bitter. So just go a little easy. You can always add in more if you want to. I'm adding my 2 cloves of garlic. I'm adding the share of salt. I had cooked the chickpeas without salt, so salt needs to go in. And another important is lemon juice. That's something that's going to go in as well. I'm starting with half. I'm going to blend all this. If I need more, I will add. What's happened. Okay, it's all coming together. Now here is the trick to have a very smooth kind of a hummus. This is what goes in right now. It's basically, I'm dropping in few ice cubes, small size, 4 of them, and I'm adding a dash of cold water. dash of ice cold water is what goes in now. Okay, just a little bit. Do not go overboard with water, please. The hummus will get extremely runny. Let's see. Okay, it's getting there. A little bit more water. Let's see what's happening. Just scrape the edges. Okay, I'm gonna give this a taste just to see if I need anything more. I'm gonna add in more lime juice. So this also is an additional liquid that is going in. I'm okay with the salt. And I'm also okay with the tahini paste. I'm not gonna add that more. Adding a little bit of the aquafaba which is remaining, just a little bit. Can you see? That's about it. Let's see what's happening. Okay, it's much more easy to move around. It's getting creamier. Okay, but I'm still going to give it another blend. Let's see what's happening here now. Can you see that? Can you see this? Can you see the creamy texture? Now, if you want your hummus to be a little bit more thicker, you can always add tahini paste. If you want it to be a little bit more thinner, then you can add a little bit of water or some more lemon juice, depending on what you want to add. So this is the creamy texture is what we are looking at. Look at that. It was so simple, basic ingredients, just the soaking, just the pressure cooking, cooking the chickpeas, and there you have an excellent homemade hummus. Now let's go ahead and plate this out because I got a lot of questions on the plating as well. So let's come here and plate this out. I have a very standard bowl. Try get a wide mouth bowl because it will be easy for you to present the dish. So this is where now I'm going to start making the, let me take out the hummus from the food processor. It's nice and creamy. A lot of recipes do call for adding cumin powder, jeera powder in the hummus. I prefer not to, it kind of changes the color. But yes, it can go on top as a garnish, so keep that option open instead of putting it while processing. Keep this as basic and neutral as you can on flavors. We can add flavors later. So this is all the hummus that I managed to make. Okay, there it is. Now let's talk about giving it that shape. Okay, use a big spoon, the back of the spoon, start turning your hummus bowl. Okay, we need to create a well where we are going to be pouring in the olive oil. Okay, try make this wall, push this wall as much as you can. Okay, we are going to be flattening this curve a little bit. Try get a more neater. Okay, if you want those red fork marks you saw on the picture, then you need to have a certain kind of a depth and the area here so that you can get those marks. Now what are we going to garnish with? Olive oil. I had reserved some chickpeas to put them in later. I have a little bit of parsley leaves. Now this is the way the red fork marks come. I have a fork and I have, you can use paprika, but right now I'm using Kashmiri red chili powder. Okay, this needs to be a little bit wet, the fork. And there you go. And let's do another one here. Okay, just try and get the fork mark done. Looks nice. Okay, now moving on to olive oil. This is a must. Please do not use any colored oil, any flavored oil. It will change the entire taste of hummus. So we are going to be using olive oil. I am going to be putting some chickpeas, some cumin powder. Basically what people do believe, and probably it's true, that eating a lot of chickpeas does give you a lot of that bloating kind of feeling. So cumin apparently helps you in reducing the bloating effect. So cumin goes in, and then I am going to garnish with a little bit of a green color going in. Voila, that's it. It's ready. Can you see the hummus, everyone? It was so simple. Look at that. Look at that bowl of gorgeous, generous amount of hummus. Okay, it was simple, super simple. Now that you've seen it, I'm going to be posting the recipe, and please go make it. If you soak them 8 hours, or tonight you can soak them and you can make the hummus tomorrow. This stays in the fridge very well. This stays in the fridge very well. Give it to kids, have it as a spread in some roll. You can have it sandwich, you can have hummus crusted chicken, bake, you can have this. Look at that, just look. Yeah, and everybody keeps asking me about where I take my pictures, right? Yeah, this is where I take my pictures, and these are my plants. So look at that, this was exactly what I had posted that day. I also got asked, was this really your picture, did you take it off from Google or from internet? No, this is my hummus bowl. That was my hand in the picture. These are my plants. This is it. See, so simple. So don't waste too much time, and go ahead. If you have any questions, I am available on WhatsApp for a chat. You want to ask me anything, and that's it. As I said, this can be had. Give this to kids. Yeah, I introduce this to kids. It's extremely nutritious. So I am going to be switching the camera on other side. You can see me now instead of the hummus bowl. There I am. So how was it? I hope you enjoyed. Please make this. As I said, tonight you can, if you don't have chickpeas, go get them. Soak them tonight, pressure cook them tomorrow, and make this wonderful bowl of hummus. Okay, I hope you guys liked it, and see you again sometime next week for another recipe which I'll be doing live. Something that's healthy, nutritious, and be good, be safe, take care. Bye-bye.